स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द चैनल रुचिस टीचिंग. दिस इज रुचि हियर. इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द कॉन्स्टेंट्स इन सी. ओके, बिफोर आई स्टार्ट माई वीडियो आई वुड लाइक टू से दैट इफ यू आर न्यूली वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो प्लीज सब्सक्राइब द चैनल, लाइक इट, गिव अ लाइक टू इट, शेयर टू योर फ्रेंड्स. ओके, लेट्स एंटर इन टू द वीडियो. नाउ हियर, वॉट आर कॉन्स्टेंट्स इन सी? लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन it is a C token. Okay, already we have discussed about it. So it is a C token. So this constants, along with this constants, we have discussed about keywords and identifiers in last class. Now today in this, this is one of the C token of the C language. Okay, it is a token of the C language. Okay, now constant. What is the constant? Constant is the value given or assigned to a particular variable. Okay. So when that value is assigned, that value cannot be changed during the program execution. Okay, this value, constant value, cannot be changed during program execution, right? During program execution. And these constants are also called as literals. Okay, these constants are also called as literals. That means it is having another name called literals. And how can you declare a constant? You can declare a constant with hash define, comma, this will be the starting one, or you can say constant const, or even you can declare it as macros. Okay, you can define like this. Okay, you can declare the constants like this. Okay, this is the value cannot be changed. The value which is assigned to the particular name or variable, that value cannot be changed during the program execution, and these are also called as literals, and it can be declared in this format. Okay, hash define constant macros. Now there are different types of constants. Now we are going to discuss about the types of constants. Now constants, right? Under constants you have a numeric constants. Okay, under one is numeric constant and one is character constant. Okay, now under numeric constants you are having digits. It will take only digits as the values. Okay, and under character constant it takes the letters, that means alphabets, and other symbols also. Okay, like string type of things will be given, that type of value, string type of values can be given to the character constants, and the digit type of digits can be given, type of values can be given to the numeric constants. Now under numeric constants still you have integer constants, right? And one more constant is under numeric, real or float type constants. Now with that words only you can understand that in integers, integer constants, these integer constants are those constants which accepts only int data types. Okay, next, it accepts only int data types, and it will not take point values. Okay, point values. And third point is it accepts positive and negative symbols, numbers. Okay, understood? Under integer constants, under integer constant, it accepts only integer data types. It will not take point values. It accepts positive and negative signs. Okay. So these are about the integer constants. Now float constants are those constants which accepts only decimal values. Okay. Accepts decimal values. Okay. And integer constants, again you have infix and suffix. Okay, you have infix and suffix. Okay, and these are the things, constants, infix constants, where it indicates infix and this is suffix. Now we talk about infix. Now infix, it indicates the base of the value. It indicates the base of the value which has to be read. Which has to be read. Okay. That means, what is infix? Infix constants are those constants which indicates the base of the value which has to be read. Okay, it indicates the base. Okay, now under this infix you have four types. Okay, under this infix you have four types of constants. First one is decimal, integer, constants. Now under this decimal integer constant, it will take the base value as 10. Okay, it will take the base value as 10. Now here, what all you have to, how you have to declare the integer, decimal integer constants, I'll be telling now. Now in this you can use from 0 to 9 values, digits. Okay, 0 to 9 digits you can use. You can use 0 to 9 digits and it will take point values and it will also take positive and negative values. Okay, it will take positive and negative values and always you have to check that it should not start with 0. Should not start with 0. Okay. For example, how you have to take is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Or even you can say 4 minus 4, 5, 6. Like this you can use the values. Okay, you can take this type of values. Okay, this is for decimal integer constant. Once again I will repeat, decimal integer constant will have base as 10 and it can take digits from 0 to 9. It will take point values. Okay, even it will take point values and it will take positive and negative values. It will not take point values. Okay, now because it is an integer constant, no, if only point values will be taken by float type. Okay, sorry, it can use only digits from 0 to 9 and it has a positive, it can use positive and negative values and it should not start with 0. Okay, these are the examples. Even you can use the negative sign or positive sign, start with that sign. But you should never use zero for this type of decimal integer constants. Okay, next is octal integer constants. Okay, next one is octal integer constants. Octal integer constants. Now these constants base value will be from octal integer constant base value will be 8. Okay, so how you can declare the values here? You must start with 0. You must start with 0. Okay, and next is you can use digits from 0 to 7. Okay, from 0 to 7 you can use digits from 0 to 7 and you have to start it with only 0. For example, 0, 1, 2, 3, comma, and 4, 6, 7. Okay, till 7 only you can use in this octal integer constant. Okay, once again I will repeat, octal integer constant. This is the constant of the from the infix. These are the types I am telling. Octal integer constant base will be 8. So it must start with 0 only, and digits which you have to take in this is only from 0 to 7. And the, for example, I am showing here, you have to start with 0 only. So compulsory 0 should be there. Okay, without 0 it will not accept. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3 or 0, 4, 6, 7. Okay, you can use like this. Next is hexadecimal integer constant. Okay, hexadecimal integer constant. Hexadecimal integer constant. The base value for this is 16. Okay, the base value for this is 16. Now here you can use the values, or you can start with 0 to 9. You can start the values, or you can use the digits from 0 to 9, and alphabets you can use from capital A to capital F, or you can use small letters A to small letter F. Understood? You can use 0 to 9 digits, and you can use capital letters from A to F, or even you can use A to F. Okay, small letters, capital letters you can use, small letters you can use, lowercase and uppercase also you can use, but you have to use from A to F only. Okay, and you have to start with letter OX. You have to start with letter OX like this, or OX, small letters. Okay, like this you have to use. Understood? Hexadecimal integer constants base value will be 16. Here you can use digits from 0 to 9, alphabets from uppercase alphabets from A to F, lowercase alphabets from A to F. Okay, and you have to start the constant name of that constant with OX or capital OX or small letters OX. Okay, for example you have to use like this 5. Okay, or you can use A F 1 like this also you can use. That means you can use whatever you want, or you can use like this also, but starting this should be compulsory. Okay, starting that should be compulsory. Okay, and you can use like this also 1, 2. Okay, so these are the examples for the hexadecimal. And next is binary integer constants. Okay, binary integer constant. Here the base value will be 2. right? Now, how you can declare the values? Here only digits you can take is only two digits, only two digits, that is zeros and ones. Understood? Only two digits you can use for this, and those are also zeros and ones. Okay, and you have to start with OB or O capital B. Okay, like this you can start. I'll show you how. For example, OB zeros, because I said only zeros and ones, like this, only zeros and ones, or OB 00110, like this. Okay, only zeros and ones are digits are used in this. Okay, you have to start with like O small letter and O big capital letter B. Understood? This is the binary integer constant base value it will take as two, and only two digits, it zeros and ones are used in this, and you have to start with OB, O small letter B, or O big capital letter B. Okay, so these are all the integer constants. Till now what all we have learnt? Decimal integer constants, octal integer constants, hexadecimal integer constants, and binary integer constants. Okay, these comes under the infix integer constants. Okay, all these comes under the infix integer constant. Now coming to suffix. Now just now we have said that infix is indicates the base value. Okay, base of the value. Here suffix indicates data type of the value which has to be read. Okay, data type of the value which has to be read. Okay, understood? So suffix indicates the data type of the value which has to be read. This is about the suffix. Okay, now here this suffix is not going to take, and no point values can be taken. Okay, no point values it will accept. Point values are not accepted by this suffix. And for example, you can write like this: 1, 2, 3 integer, and 1, 2, 3 u is unsigned integer. Okay, unsigned integer, and third one is 1, 2, 3 l, that means long integer constant, and even you can write like this 1, 2, 3 ul is nothing but long unsigned integer constant. Okay, so these are the examples for suffix. So suffix indicates a data type of the value which has to be read, and no point values it will take. So the suffix will not support the point values. And examples like 1, 2, 3 integer, and 1, 2, 3 u means unsigned integer, 1, 2, 3 l means long integer constant, 1, 2, 3 ul means long unsigned integer constant. So this is about the suffix. Okay, understood? So this is about the integer constants. Here infix over suffix, and this is, here you have again two. under real or float type, this will accept only point values. Okay, so under this you have decimal form and here exponential form. Okay, you have decimal form and here you have decimal form and then exponential form under real or float type. Okay, okay, now coming to real or float type, here you have decimal form and exponential form. Under decimal form constants are those constants which gives or indicate or shows the decimal part. Okay, it will show the decimal part of the value, decimal part of the value. For example, here suppose like 3.142, right? 3.142 and minus 3.256. Okay, like this you can point. So this, it is showing the decimal part here, right? So that's why this is a decimal form of the integer constants. Now this is about the decimal form. Now under exponential form, under exponential form, now this is about the decimal form. Okay, and one more is the exponential form. In this form, it will show the number of decimal fractional parts. Okay, it will show the number of decimal fractional part. For example, now e, that means this is the e is the exponential form. This is the symbol for the exponential form. This will show this, that means it represents the decimal part of the fractional part, number of decimal. This e represents the number of decimal fractional parts. How? For example, I will tell you. Now 1 2 3 e 12, suppose if I write like this, this is what it is indicating, is 1 2 3 in e place, e into 10 to the power of 12. Now this is the fractional part. Okay, you can write this as 1 2 3 into 10 1 by sorry only 10 to the power of 12. Now I will tell you one more example. 1 2 3 e minus 12. Suppose this is like this, what you have to think is that meaning of this is 1 2 3 into 10 to the power of minus 12, right? Now this can be written as 1 2 3 into 1 by 10 to the power of 12. So how you can understand this, it is showing this part. So this part is shown by this e. Okay, understood? It is showing the exponential form. Exponential form is nothing but that value is represented by e, and e is showing number of decimal fractional parts in the value. For example, this one, 1 2 3 into 10 to the power of 12. Okay, understood? So this is about the exponential form. And now I'll tell you one thing. 1 2 3 e 12, this 1 2 3 is called as mantissa, and this 12 part is called as exponent. Okay, this is mantissa and you will call these numbers as mantissa and this as exponent. Okay, understood? The 1 2 3 is mantissa and 1 2 here fractional part it is showing, now that one is exponent form. Okay, understood? This is about the exponential form. Understood? So under real or float type, you have decimal form, exponential form, under decimal form, it will indicate the number of decimal, like decimal part it will indicate. It will show the decimal part here. And in exponential form, it shows the number of decimal fractional parts. Okay. So this is about the real or float. Okay. Coming to character constants. Till now we have seen about the integer constant, real constant. Now we'll go for the character constant. Now I said character constants will take the letters and symbols. So now here in character constants you have three types. One is string constant. Another one is single character constant. Okay, single character constant, and third one is backslash character constant. Now I'll discuss about the string. Okay, string constant, single character constant, backslash character constant under character constant. So now single character, now I'm taking explaining the single character, string constant. Now under string constant you have characters enclosed within the double quotes. Okay, characters enclosed within the, here in the string constant, characters are enclosed within the double quotes. For example, hello, like this. So this one is nothing but hello is the string. Okay, and marks. Okay, so like this, double quotes, within double quotes, if you enter a string, then it is a string constant. Okay, now this is about the string constant. Now I will explain about single character constant. Now what is single character constant? Single character constant is, with word only you can understand, single means a single letter. Single letter is enclosed within single quotes. Okay, single character is enclosed, or single letter is enclosed within the single quotes. For example, A, like this. For example, F, like this. Understood? Okay, so this is about the single character constant. Okay, now single character constant. Now backslash character constants. What are backslash character constants? Backslash. Okay, what is backslash? By the word only you can say that the word means that backslash. This indicates, what it indicates? It indicates a special meaning. Okay, this indicates a special meaning. Indicates special meaning, and this is executed directly by the compiler. Okay, this is executed directly by the compiler. Okay, understood? This is executed directly by the compiler. Now you have some slash with letter. I will tell you. First one, slash T shows the, indicates the horizontal tab. Slash V indicates vertical tab. Slash R indicates return. Slash A, it is the audible sound, indicates the audible sound, or you can get some beep sound. If you give this, it will give out the beep sound. okay, and one more is slash n, it goes to next line. Okay, now just listen once again. Backslash character constants are those constants which indicates the special meaning like this, and it is directly executed by the compiler, right? Now under this you have, I have given some examples, many are there. Slash t means, backslash t means horizontal tab, that means it, the horizontal tab works over there. Backslash v means vertical tab will work. Backslash r means return statement is working there. And slash backslash a means audible sound is given out, or a beep sound comes. And the backslash n is nothing but it goes to the next line. So these are all about the backslash character constants. Now we have completed the all the constants. Okay, now just once again I will read the constants here again. Constants are of two types. First, numeric constants, character constants. Under numeric constants you have integer constants in real and real float type constants. So integer constants will take only integer data types, no point values are accepted here, and float value will accept the point values. Okay, under integer constants, you have infix and again suffix. Now infix will indicates the base of the value which has to be read, and suffix indicates here, I will write, indicates the data type of the value. Okay, suffix indicates the data type. Under infix again, infix you have decimal integer constant, octal integer constant, hexadecimal integer constant, and binary integer constant in infix. In suffix only this is there, data type will be like this. Data type indicates the data type of the value. Now coming to the real or float type, here you have two forms, decimal form and exponential form. Decimal part, it will show the decimal. Decimal form will show the decimal part of the value, and here exponential form will show the number of decimal fractional parts, right? Number of decimal fractional parts. Okay, it will show only the decimal part. Okay, next come to the character constant. Under character constants it will take the characters. You have string constant, single character constant, backslash character constant. Now under string constant it will be the whole string will be enclosed within the double quotes, and in single character constant the single character, when single letter or single character is enclosed within the single quotes. Okay, backslash character constants are those constants which indicate the special meaning, and it is executed directly by the compiler, and you have all these things here. Okay, understood? So these are the constants in C language. I hope you understood it properly. Still, if you have any doubts in this, please let me know through comment section. I will try to clear your doubts. Okay, then so I will end up this class now. If you like this video, please give a like to it, share to your friends, and try to subscribe the channel. Please support the channel. Okay, then thank you. Bye.